you. What a wonderful day. What a magnificent crowd. What a momentous spirit here today. And I want to just begin. I want to begin by thanking someone who has become, for me, one of my very closest friends, a brother, a son, Grady Keefe of my office, who many of you know and who has helped to lead nationally. And unfortunately, he is leaving my staff to go to work for Hillary Clinton. Now, there are some who might say, how could he possibly leave Blumenthal to go to work for Clinton? But I understand. And I want to thank so many who are here today for your leadership, your vision, your courage, your strength, and your friendship to me. I came here, I planned to come here to talk about the Stonewall riots. This day, we were to mark that momentous day in our history. And we have to recall all who came before us, all who brought us to this time and place, all who share in the responsibility and maybe aren't here today to share in our joy. Your courage and strength, and the courage and strength of so many who brought us here today at such great sacrifice, have served our nation. Today, this ruling affirms why we are the greatest, strongest nation in the history of the world. Because we respect every person's right to equal liberty, equal justice under the law, equal rights, no matter who they are or where they live or whom they love. And today will go down as momentous for all Americans. Every single American alive today, and all of our children and our grandchildren. Because this ruling makes us an even stronger beacon of hope and opportunity for the whole world. Right down the street here, on Fridays, like today, you can go to a ceremony where people become citizens of this country. 60 to 70 of them at each ceremony, three or four in a day, every Friday in the state of Connecticut. People become citizens of this great country. Why do they come here? Because we believe that every person is equal and ought to have equal rights and an equal right to marry whomever they love. That's this nation. That's why people come here. That's why we are the greatest, strongest nation in the history of the world, bar none. Today, the United States Supreme Court gave all of us the equal right to marry. But it did not give us the right to be free of discrimination in the workplace, in our homes, when we buy homes, and in public accommodations. It did not guarantee equality in many places where now it is denied, in many states where it is not a right, and in many places, even within this nation, where it has to be a right. LGBT individuals in this country still don't enjoy the equal right to work, the equal right to choose where to live, or the equal right to enjoy public accommodations. If you're gay, a justice cannot deny you the right to marry. He cannot, or she cannot, deny you a marriage license simply because you are of the same sex. But a landlord can evict you, an employer can deny you the right to work, and a business can refuse to open their doors to you. This is the sad legacy of another time in this country that we need to eradicate. We need to make sure that Congress finishes the work, that this decision will give us the momentum and the spirit to finish. We need to make sure that Congress does its job. And I pledge to you that I will make sure that Congress finishes this work and we continue to be, as a nation, a work in progress until we give every person equal justice, equal rights to all of the opportunities that everyone in this great nation enjoys. Let's work on it together. Let's come together as a nation behind equal justice for all on this great day and pledge we will not rest. We will not rest. We will not be complacent. We will not take for granted anyone's rights until they are everyone's rights and until justice is for all. Thank you so much.